Good morning, students. Today we are going to see inner and outer orbital complexes. Generally, this concept comes into picture when there is the bonding in octahedral complexes with two types of hybridization, that is D2SP3 and SP3D2. See here, Pauling's theory faces difficulties when the number of orbitals needed to accommodate the bonding electrons is too low. This can result from the occupancy of the orbitals by earlier pair or unpaired electrons from the metal ion. As an example, we can consider the complex ion FeF6-3- and NiNH3+6-2+, which have magnetic moment corresponding to 5 and 2 unpaired electrons respectively. In either of these cases, it is not possible to have D2SP3 hybridization of the central metal ion. As shown here, there are only for orbitals 4s and 4p of approximately the same energy beyond occupied the d orbitals. See here, in FeF6-3, 3d orbital have the 5 unpaired electrons and it shows related magnetic moment. So here it cannot take part into bonding. Here 4s, 4p and 4d orbital can take part into the bonding, and hybridization must be sp3d2. Same is the case for NiNH3+6-2+. See here, in this complex, in 3d orbital 2 unpaired electrons, and its magnetic moment, actually magnetic moment, it corresponds to the 2 electrons. Hence it also not use the 3d orbital, and so it use the 4d orbital, and hybridization is the sp3d2 hybridization. Pauling overcome this difficulty by assuming that such complexes are premier ligand ionic. That is, he assumed that the metal orbitals were left free to accommodate only metal ions electrons, and the bonding electrons were contained in a separated orbitals located primarily on the ligand. The introduction of the term ionic was not proper, because some complexes of these type, such as FeAcAc3b, have like covalent compounds. On the other hand, Pauling postulated that in the case of strong electron donating ligands, such as Cn-, covalent bond formation would occur even if required in some cases by coupling of electrons to provide the necessary orbitals for the hybridization. He called such a complexes as covalent. Thus, Pauling made a subdivision of complexes into ionic and covalent, and the observed magnetic moment was used to decide the white kind of complex is. The magnetic criteria of the bond type. Huygens in 1937 proposed that outer d orbital might be used in the bond formation. However, that time it was generally considered that the 4d orbital would not hybridize satisfactorily with 4s and 4p orbitals to give a strong covalent octahedral bonds. Later on, Krag shows that with highly electronegative ligands, the use of 4d orbital probably leads to stronger bond than those formed by 4s and 4p orbitals alone. Thus, the complexes originally described by Pauling as ionic where is supported to use outer d orbitals, and covalent R is supposed to use inner d orbital for covalent bonding. In general, inner orbital octahedral complexes use n-1d2 ns np3 orbitals and show d2 sp3 hybridization, and outer orbital octahedral complexes use ns np3 and nd2 orbitals and show sp3 d2 hybridization, where n is the principal quantum number of the outermost cell. In other words, the octahedral complexes like CO, NH36, 3+, which use n-1d, ns, and np orbitals of the metal ion to show d2 sp3 hybridization, are called inner orbital complexes, whereas in the octahedral complexes like Ni, NH36, 2+, in which Ns, Np, and Nd orbitals of the metal ion are used to show sp3d2 hybridization, are called outer orbital complexes. Different names are suggested by different scientists for two types of complexes. See these names. Pauling's can formerly use the covalent, later on hyperligand, formerly ionic, later on hyperligand. Tobey, inner orbital and outer orbital. Nyholm, spin paired and spin free complexes. Orgel, low spin complexes and high spin complexes. Most often, these terms have lost their significance now, and the only term still in use are high spin and low spin, and spin free and spin paired. See, formation of inner and outer orbital complexes with d2 sp3 hybridization in case of d1, d4, d5, d6 and d7 and d8 ions of first transition series elements on the basis of VBT are shown here. See the ion d4. When it shows the d2 sp3 hybridization, first d4 can show the 4 unpaired electrons, but as it accepts the d2 sp3 hybridization, there are only 2 unpaired electrons. One electron will be get shifted, it will be get paired. Then for the d5, there are 5 unpaired electrons in ground state, but in the hybridized state, 2 electrons will be shifted into the 3d orbital, and it shows only 1 unpaired electrons. D6 system, D2 sp3 hybridization, there are 4 unpaired electrons, but 2 unpaired electrons will be shifted and all electrons will be get paired, and it shows D2 sp3 hybridization. D7 system, now here 1 electron can be shifted in 3D orbital and one electron will be shifted into 5s orbital and it will be make the 2d orbitals empty and hybridization is the d2sp3. And lastly, d8 system, in this case there are the two unpaired electrons in ground state, but these two orbital must be empty, hence these two orbitals are get excited, they are shifted in 5s orbital and we having the d2sp3 hybridization, and thus we have the no any unpaired electrons in this case. Now we are going to see the formation of outer orbital octahedral complexes with sp3d2 hybridization. In case of d4, d5, d6, d7 and d8 ions of first transition series elements on the basis of VBT. See d4 system. In the d4 system or d4 ion, primarily in ground state there are 4 unpaired electrons. In hybridizer state it does not use the 3D orbital, it shows use the 4D orbital and shows hybridization sp3d2, and hence the electrons of 3D remains as it is and thus it have the 4 unpaired electrons. Then d5 ions, in d5 ions also it use the outer d orbital, inner d orbital, that is the 3D orbital having the 5 unpaired electrons. After bonding or hybridization they shows the 5 unpaired electrons. In d6 system also it does not disturb the 3D orbital, instead of it use the outer 4D orbital and there are 4 unpaired electrons in the complex. Similar is the case for the d7. It does not use the 3D orbital, it use the 4D orbital, and so there are 3 unpaired electrons before the hybridization and after the hybridization or in bonding, and thus it is the 3 unpaired electrons. Same is the case in case of the d8 system. In d8 system there are 2 unpaired electrons in ground state. 3D orbital is not used for the bonding, it use the 4D orbital for the bonding and shows the sp3d2 hybridization, thus there are the 2 unpaired electrons. Thus we see the inner and outer orbital complexes with the d4 system to the d8 system. Now we are going to see multiple bonding in complexes. Pauling consider multiple bonding in the complexes. One of the assumptions of VBT says that ligand must contain at least one lone pair of electrons for the purpose of donation and forming sigma bond. There are many ligands such as CO, RCN, RX3, PR3, SR3, SR2, etc., which are very poor electron pair donor, and yet they form many stable metal complexes. Pauling supposes that atoms of the transition metals are capable of forming multiple bonds with electron acceptor in group by making use of electron and orbitals of the shell below the valence shell. That is, in addition to sigma bond, a pi bond may be formed between metal and ligand. In this case, electron donated by the metal to the ligand to form pi bond. This is called back bonding, in which the metal shares its own pair of electron with the ligand, offsets the accumulation of negative charge on the metal and the strength of the sigma bond. There are two types of pi bonding found in complexes. First, donation of electrons from metal d orbitals, that is dxy, dyz and dxz, to the empty p orbitals of the ligand. This type of ligand is generally referred to as d pi p pi bonding. It occurs when the ligand contains an atom from second row, for example N in NO2, C, and CO or C in CN. And second type of the pi bonding, donation of electrons from metal d orbital dx, dy and dz to empty d orbitals of the ligand. This type of bonding is generally referred as d pi bonding. It occurs when the ligand contains an atom from third or higher row, for example P, S, etc. atoms. One example of the each should to illustrate pi bonding, the NiC bond distance in NiCO4 is shorter than the expected for a single bond. This suggests that the bond between the Ni and CO appreciably double bond character. The valence bond representation of the metal and carbon double bond requires the carbon-oxygen bond to be changed to double bond in order to vacate the p orbitals for d pi p pi bonding. This is shown in the figure we see in the next slide. Similarly, let us consider a bonding between a metal like nickel, which has an available on bonding pair of electrons, and element like, that is the ligand like PX3, which is poor leave in base, Lewis base. The filled d orbital on the metal overlaps with one of the empty d orbitals of the phosphorus, giving rise to d pi bonding. See in the figure NiCO bond. First it formed the sigma bond, and then Ni nickel's filled d orbital overlaps on empty p orbitals of carbon, and we having the d pi p pi bonding. Last, we are going to see the limitations of the valence bond theory. Valence bond theory, when applied to the complexes, it have some drawbacks. First drawback, it gives only qualitative explanation regarding the structure, bonding and magnetic properties of the complex. It fails to give any quantitative explanation of these properties. Second, it cannot explain or interpret the spectra of the complex. Third one, it cannot explain why certain complexes are more labile than the other complexes. Fourth, VBT cannot account for predict detailed magnetic properties. Fifth, in VBT, it is assumed that all d orbitals are of equal energy. It does not consider the splitting of d energy levels. 6. Limitation. It does not account for the relative energies of different structures. 7. It fails to account for the observed geometry of certain complexes, that is tetragonal and distorted octahedral complexes. 8. It does not tell us why water and halide ions commonly form high spin complexes, while cyanide ion form low spin complexes. For example, NiCl4-2- is high spin complex with tetrahedral geometry, and NiCN4-2- is low spin complex with square planar geometry. Ninth, it does not give us any satisfactory reason for the formation of inner orbital and outer orbital complexes. As this theory have these limitations, but it was somewhat accepted. In spite of these limitations, it can be said that PBT is simple and easy to apply, and make it is good beginning to explain the many things about the